first, there was nothing. It all started when a thing exploded in the middle of nowhere. Then suddenly a giant man appeared in the sky and made a big rock with things on it. They were called plants. Then he created these living creatures called humans. Soon these humans created whole civilizations that spoke Latin. But then a new language called English came along and killed all the Latin people. Soon Latin was forgotten and no one knew about it. Then a man called Moses went up a hill and found not the Ten Commandments, but Ecce Romani, Volume 1, 2, and 3. This saved everyone and brought peace to the land. Let's take a look at a world where Ecce Romani never existed at all.
It's not just a challenge as far as design, but as features and technology. On Ecce Romani 3, we implemented a new feature called Clap to Open. You simply sit down and clap your hands twice, and it opens. This, we think, is revolutionary. No one will have to touch their book ever again.
If only I had a way to open this book without actually touching it. Oh wait, I do!
Another thing many Ecce Romani users wanted was a way to read their Ecce Romani in the dark. So, Ecce Romani 3 is backlit. That's right, you just push a button and a light will come on, illuminating your page. That way you can continue reading Latin into the early hours of the morning.
Man, it's so dark. Much better.
We know that with Apple Maps, we... messed up. So what we did with Ecce Romani 3 is create a new map system. It's called Ecce Maps. Okay, give me directions to the Colosseum.
Getting directions to Roman Colosseum. Turn right onto the Appian Way. Continue straight for 12 hectares. Look out for that tree. Ouch, you dropped me.
There have been many reports of people forgetting their Ecce Romani. So we created a new feature to combat this. Ecce Romani 3 has Snap to Human, a new intuitive feature that allows the Ecce Romani to come to its owner. All you have to do is snap your fingers, and the Ecce Romani will come right to you wherever you are. Man, I forgot my Ecce Romani. Oh wait, that's right.
For our old Ecce Romani books, we chose the color green. But for our newest Ecce Romani book, we decided decided to ask you what you wanted, and we discovered that green is obsolete. For our newest Ekiromani installment, we chose the color orange. You see, orange really brings out the color in most human beings. And it really helps to capture the human element.
With the new Ekiromani 3, we needed to make sure that it was different enough to catch people's attention. So, as well as changing the colors, we also changed the dimensions. While being the same height and width as Ekiromani 2, Ekiromani 3 is 18% thinner and 20% lighter. Now, because it's 18% thinner, that means you'll be able to fit it into tighter spaces with no trouble at all. Ekiromani Volume 2 is now obsolete. One topic that we took into account when creating Ekiromani 3 is obsolenity. With Ekiromani Volume 2, there was a lot of obsolenity. The color was obsolete, everything about it was obsolete. So, with Volume 3, we decided to remove the obsolenity from the obsolete. Obsolete.
Obsolete.
Obsolete.
Obsolete.
Obsolete. As an amateur photographer, I used Ekiromani Volume 2 really frequently. But when Ekiromani Volume 3 came out, I realized that I was using something that was obsolete. Now, I use Ekiromani 3 for everything.
With Ekiromani Volume 3, I can schedule my appointments, learn Latin. In fact, I can even contact all the people I work with, all from one book.